joined our panel. You know, you all know Dr. Dale Archer. He's on the Strategy Room all the time. Well, his son, Trey Archer, is here with us. And you live like half the time with your dad in Louisiana. So I just asked during the commercial break what the reaction was down there, because the oil's about to start coming up on the beaches.
Yep, I think it already has started coming up on the beaches. But pretty much the mood is the same throughout the entire country, Louisiana to New York to California. I don't think anybody's too happy with what happened. It's an environmental catastrophe. So.
Yes. All right. Well, good. You're in the right place, because we're not too happy with it right now. But you started this website because you're recently out of college, and then it's kind of hard to get a job right now, correct? So you're
Absolutely.
Like, I'm going to go travel.
That's exactly what happened. Actually, in 2007, after my junior year abroad, I spent half a year in Argentina and another half the year in Brazil. And I had to get back to finish my senior year in college, so I decided to travel back to the United States by land. And after that, I realized that I loved traveling. And being graduating in the class of 2008, there wasn't too much job opportunity. So I decided to put the whole corporate world on hold and decided to travel for as much time as possible. But after doing it 2 years now, I decided not to look back, and I love it.
You went to Brazil?
Yes.
Sorry, tell me about Brazil. I love it. It's awesome.
It's a great country.
Beautiful people, beautiful place.
Yeah. I've been to Rio de Janeiro 3 times. It's like one
I love
of my
Brazil.
Favorite places.
Absolutely. This is so interesting. I mean, this is such a testament to the times with regard to, you know, just people graduating and just having
such an
opportunity.
You obviously had saved up money, right?
Yes, and I teach English abroad, too. I was last living in China. And if you teach there, they will pay for your plane ticket there. You make a salary there. They give you an apartment to stay in. And they'll also pay for your plane ticket back.
But don't you have to know Chinese to be able to teach?
Actually, I arrived in China without speaking a word, not even ni hao or hello in Chinese. And after a year, after a complete immersion, you really end up learning a lot.
The best way to
say
learn.
Say something to us.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Say something to us in Chinese.
Ni hao. Jin dao ni. Heng kai xing.
What an amazing experience that you've done, just because you were not willing to kind of just take a job, like any job you could get, and you wanted to follow your passion. I mean, I think that's, Gabby, I think that's what you were saying.
So
like that generation, you guys are so fortunate that you have like almost like a built-in entrepreneurial spirit.
That's right.
It don't work for anybody.
But
you
did.
You
did.
Don't ever work for anybody.
You have started up this site.
Don't ever work for anybody.
Trey, so you started up a site.
Yes.
You know, about your travels and everything. ExtremeTravelStories.com.
That's
I went there. And people can submit their own stories, and you have some prizes on there, and there's videos and all that stuff.
Absolutely.
Tell you shoot videos?
Well, actually, I posted some of my own stories, but we also take stories, freelance reports, photographs, videos from other people as well. And every quarter, we will pay the winning author of the best story $100. Nice. So we will reward you for traveling, basically.
Great. You should get a flip camera. Do you have a flip camera?
Yeah, I have a camera, and also, exactly.
And are you, I guess you're looking for advertisements, right? Or like people, is that how the site kind of keeps up and running?
Exactly, yeah, through advertisements.
Okay. And so we want to help you promote that site, of course, so you can get more clicks, so you can sell more ad spots, right?
It's good for the users, Trey, because they can find out about other places, they can have relatable travel stories, and what else?
Is there social networking?
Well, we have a forum where you can post different things, and pretty much anything you want, if you know a good place to stay in a country. Mm-hmm. If you've unfollowed a scam, you can put that as well. So we really try to be travel-friendly.
And it comes up in Google searches, right?
Yes, it will.
That's key, because I just went to Puerto Rico 2 weekends ago, and I had never been, and I was like looking for a recommendation.
Where'd you go?
Or whatever.
What part of Puerto Rico?
Isla Verde. It's outside of San Juan. I don't know. I found it on Google.
Wow.
And then you read, it's helpful to read the reviews
Google.
Of hotels. I'm obsessed with Google.
The Google? Would you recommend that place?
Did I say that? Yes. You can take pets there. It's like the only hotel that allows
pets. Did you take your dog?
Did you bring Stoli on your trip?
We brought my dog, and he ate all this sand because like my husband was throwing the Frisbee to him, so every time he'd like pick the Frisbee up, he was obviously swallowing all the sand. So then he threw up everywhere in the
hotel.
That's awesome. Stoli also ate your dog.
That's an extreme travel story.
Yeah, post it.
But I was scared that, you know, he was going to, because he's had obviously issues with eating things and surgeries, so I was scared that he was going to have a surgery there. We were going to have to come back. He was going to be stuck in Puerto Rico.
How much have you dropped on that dog over the years?
Well,
like
pet
30
insurance.
Grand?
I totally recommend pet insurance.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Pet insurance covers 90%, but apparently there's like a $20,000 cap. So we're at like $7,000. So he can only really have like 2 more surgeries. And
leave some stuff on the floor for
and
me.
And once they have one surgery, it like happens. It's very
right.
prone to happening again.
So cute.
I love that dog, though. I mean, I totally get the whole thing, like the love between a dog owner and their dog. I took the key to the sector. He was